Hello everyone. In this video, I will explain how to implement SAD type 1 in Talend. As you can see, I have a source file which has employee number, employee name, salary, HRA, department number. So what will happen in SAD type 1? During first run, all records will be inserted as those records won't be there in the target. From next run onwards, if the records are present, those will be updated, and that will be based on the employee number. And if the records are not present, it will be inserted. If the records are present, those will be updated. And at the end, ETL load date will be also loaded. Let me go to Talend. And this is what I will do. I'll use other file as a source using this T file input delimited component. I'll use this target for doing a lookup or to join to identify whether the records are present or not in the target. Using T map, I will join those two tables, source and target, and I will generate the ETL load date. Then there are two more components, the DB output oracle. One flow is for insert, other flow is for update. As you can see in TMap, I have generated two output flows, insert flow. Insert, how I will identify whether the record is to be inserted? I'll check based on the join on employee number and employee number in target. I'll identify whether the record is present. So if is null employee number, then it means the record is not there in target, so that will be inserted. For update flow, if it is not is null, means the record is present, then it will be updated. And for update flow, you have to mention the key. You have to select the key field here. And if you go to the target, here action and data will be insert. For update flow, action and data will be update. Now let's go to the file. You can see there are four records: employee number, employee name, salary, HR, department number. This is 1, 140, 10. Up to 4, 7, 115, 40, 40. Let's run the job. Job has completed. Let's go to the database. As you can see, this talent underscore SCD1 table was empty. Let's refresh this. We can see four records have been inserted. Now, let's go to the file. Okay. Now, change the salary to 105 and HRA to 145. Make it 120. 48, and add one more record, 5, duration, it will be 125, 50, and department is 50. That's it. So what we did, we updated two records and inserted one record. So what will happen in this case? During the job runs, one record will be inserted and two records will be updated. As you can see previously, four records went to the insert flow, no records went to the update flow. Let's run the job now. I have to save the file. Run the job. Java is completed, as you can see, as we inserted one record, one new record, one row went to the insert flow. And the other records went to the update flow. Okay, it is throwing error. Okay, based on the data, actually we have selected or mentioned ename length as 6, but from source it came as 9 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8. Now let's run the job again, or let me add more and one more row. You can see two records inserted and four records into the update flow. Now let's go to the database. Now refresh this. You can see previously Ranjan 140 right there. Let's see. You can see the updated records from source have been also updated in the target. It was 100, it became 105, and HRF was 40, it became 45. And we added two new records, those also got updated. Even for the four record four, this HRA also got updated. At the same time, that ETL load date also will be updated, as we have added the current date. So in this way, the SCD works, SCD type 1 works. And from job perspective, you can see only we have around 3 or 4 types of component are used for implementing SCD. One is the source. As it's a file, we have used this file input delimiter. Then to do a lookup on the target table, we have to use that DB input. Then tmap is for joining. And adding some values for any fields, then the target component for inserting and updating records. In this case, it's a DB output. Thank you.